If you paste a poster on a wall, you will be arrested. There is no room for hunger strike. There is no freedom of speech or room for any form of protest. Hence, Tibetans are saying, self-immolation is one way left. Now, economic marginalization in Lhasa, in Tibet, towards Tibetan people. 70% of shop, restaurants, and hotels in Lhasa, the capital city, are owned or run by Chinese. In fact, there's a picture, it's available if you Google it, it's on the internet. There's a signboard outside the Chinese shop in Lhasa. Lhasa means, in Tibetan word, Lhasa means land of gods. Ha means God, Sa means land of gods. It's precious to us. Now in a Chinese store in Lhasa, there's a signboard which says, if you want a job, apply. But if you are Chinese, we give you 50 renminbi a day. If you are Tibetan, we give you 30 renminbi a day. How would you feel if there is a signboard outside Jamia, which says that if you are Chinese, we give you 50 rupees a day. If you are Indian, we give you 30 rupees a day. Blatant discrimination. Now, cultural assimilation, religious freedom. If you are caught with a picture of His Holiness the Dalai Lama, I'm sorry to say, Vice Chancellor, you have a picture of His Holiness in your office, you will be arrested. Not only that, Chinese government established what they call Democratic Management Committee in 7,000 plus monasteries in Tibet Autonomous Region that they have declared. What does this committee, which is called democratic, does? They are the ones which allows you to stay in the monastery or not. You are made to look at the picture of Dalai Lama and spit on it. Criticize. If you don't, you will be arrested. You will be expelled from the monastery. Now, Tibetan language. The Jamia Millia University, the need for it was felt so that the minorities and others could preserve the language and culture. At university level, Chinese is the medium of instruction in Tibet. At high school level, medium of instruction is Chinese. Middle school level, medium of instruction is Chinese. Now, even now, they're imposing it even at primary school level. That's why it's children are in the streets protesting. So, and environmentally, environment destruction. Now it's just not an issue of Tibet. If you look at the environment, it is connected to whole the Himalayan belt, South Asia and Asia as a whole. Tibet is called the third pole in the world. After Antarctica and Arctic, Tibet has the third highest reserve of ice. The difference being, when the ice of Tibet melts, Tibetan plateau, it turns into fresh water. Hence, the 10 largest rivers of Asia flow from Tibet. Of course, nowadays, yesterday you read that the Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu and Karnataka are talking about how to share Kaveri River. Not just that. Tibet's river, Satluj River, it flows, it originates in Tibet, goes through Kashmir to Pakistan. Indus River starts in Tibet, goes through again India to Pakistan. Indus River is special because the 60% of Indus River, fresh water of Indus River, is the snow that melts in Tibet. Brahmaputra River from Tibet to India to Bangladesh. Now what is the significance? Whenever you read that one third of Bangladesh is under flood, is flooded, it has direct relationship to deforestation that is taking place in Tibet. You cut the trees, and environmentalists will say, when there's a rain, monsoon season, there's a landslides, because of the silting, riverbed rises, it causes flood downstream. The flood in Bangladesh has direct relationship to deforestation in Tibet. Mekong and Salween River, the famous Mekong River, which flows all the way to Thailand, Cambodia, Laos, Vietnam. Yangtze River, the famous Yangtze River of China. Yellow River, all of it starts in Tibet. So Tibet is environmentally vital for Asia. Of course, all these countries are drinking Tibet's water. And as a traditional steward of Tibet's plateau, we are happy to share Tibet's natural resources, including water. Because as the Garshan, and as for Buddhism, we respect the natural flow of rivers. And we don't have water sharing issue so far. But when CEO of Bangladesh, Mamta Didi, raised the issue about Tista River with Bangladesh, then we are also tempted to charge something, you know, about our Brahmaputra River, Indus River, or Satluj River. But historically, we have been tolerant and observant of natural flow of rivers. Now, what is the problem? Problem is, the Chinese government and the companies are building not just one, two, but 10, 20 dams per river. Thereby affecting the natural flow of rivers. Thereby affecting the livelihood of millions of people in India and in Asia, because those who survive on agriculture and fishery, they have to have natural flow of rivers. Now the worst part is yet to come. All these dams, the construction are questionable. Whether they are engineerically sound or scientifically sound or not is to be seen. They are building it for hydropower, for quick money. What will happen down the line? We don't know. That's why you read in newspaper, complaints from Arunachal Pradesh and Ladakh,